Julia secretly likes to wrestle, specifically imitating her favorite wrestler, Ric Flair. Julia enjoys long-haul flights, possibly more than the actual vacation. Julia believes that Amazon is an educational website. Julia doesn't realize there's a football game going on at St. Mark's when there's a St. Mark's football game. But most importantly, her average cuddle time has decreased from 5 minutes to 2 minutes, but I can still get Julia to cuddle. In all seriousness, Julia is a wonderful daughter. She brings great joy and light into our home. So without waiting any longer, I'd like to ask our smart, funny, caring, loving, and thoughtful daughter, Julia, to come to the stage to conduct her own bat mitzvah.
My Torah portion is about when the great ruler Moses passes away. Great leaders have people who want to follow them. Moses was considered to be a great leader because of his humility, compassion, and his ability to accept criticism, make difficult decisions, and bring people together. In the end, when Moses was on Mount Moab and couldn't go to the Promised Land, it was because of his previous mistakes. Though he had made mistakes, he had the ability to accept and learn from them. This was one of the characteristics that made him a great leader that others wanted to follow. Growing up in the digital world, my definition of follower has been very much like all of yours. But studying my Torah portion and learning about Moses' leadership has redefined how I think about the word and the kinds of people I want to follow and look up to. Moses persisted even after difficult situations. Although at times he doubted himself, he kept on pushing and telling himself that he could do it. This has been a very valuable lesson for me as I have studied and prepared for today. I have to admit that there were times over the past year when I might have doubted myself. But like Moses, I learned to persist and push through the difficult moments to stand up here in front of all of you. Everybody faces challenges throughout their life. I have learned that we all hit bumps, but there's never a good excuse to give up. After all, it's not what happens, it's how we handle it. First of all, I would like to thank you for putting this whole weekend together. Thank you for being my personal cheerleader, my best friend, and the best mom. I don't know if I can make it through life without your 10 p.m. pep talks, car dance parties, or block walks, and your phone number. I admire that you not only try to put a smile on your face, but you always put a smile on mine. Daddy, thanks for being the best dad ever. From fishing, hunting, late night snacks, Whataburger runs, and simply just hanging out with you, it is always fun. I couldn't have asked for a better dad. Thank you for making me happy when I am mad, and you sometimes even make me mad when I'm happy. Daddy, I love you so much, and I will always be your little girl. Most people are probably thinking that this is about to be one of those "you're so annoying" speeches. It was going to be, but then mom and dad said no. But seriously, Sadie, you're the best sister anyone could ever ask for. I love your competitive spirit and your outgoing attitude. Thanks for all, Thank you for constantly making me laugh and always being there, just like I will always be there for you.
Your mother and I love you very, very much. You're going to do wonderful things in this life. You're going to accomplish many great things. And I'm just excited to watch your journey. And I love you.
Whether it's scaling a rock face on a mountain or getting up at 3 a.m. to peak three mountains and hike 13 miles before sunrise while you're at camp, or completely learn Hebrew from scratch in 12 months, we admire your tenacity. You're an explorer at heart, and we love watching your excitement and your willingness to always try new things. And this innate sense of curiosity and this innate sense of wonder is something that we hope you never lose, and we know it will serve you as you grow into an adult. But no matter how adventurous you are, I still will not let you jump out of an airplane. She keeps asking. You always light up a room when you walk in. You're kind, you're funny, you're thoughtful, and you always want to do the right thing. We wish for you several things, your dad and I. One, we wish you a life of never-ending adventures. We wish for you a life full of love and happiness, surrounded by the people who love you and that you love. And we wish for your inner light that shines so brightly to never dim. And as Mimi and Papa would have said, may you live as long as you want, and never want as long as you live. We love you, mazel tov.
We love you.